And we are all set now with the IPL T20 2021 constantly going, ebbing and flowing. I mean, there's a lot happening, but as they always say, you know, the show must go on. And so the next match which we are looking forward to, which we are anticipating very highly, is a Royal Clash of sorts. Because the Royal Challengers Bangalore will be taking on the Rajasthan Royals, although both teams have had very, very contrasting fortunes in recent times. Hello everyone, I'm Shane Dias, that is Siddharth Vishwanathan, and we are here to preview the latest upcoming IPL 2021 match. And obviously, you know, Siddharth, the way that things have been going recently, you know, it's fast flowing, but I think that's in a way an advantage for teams also, because it doesn't really give them much time to dwell. And boy, I think the Rajasthan Royals of all teams definitely don't need to dwell on where they've been going wrong recently, because I don't think anything has been going right with those guys.
Exactly. I mean, Rajasthan Royals, if I may say, are in royal trouble. Ben Stokes is out. Jofra Archer, we don't know when he's going to come back. Now, even Liam Livingston is out of the IPL because he's got bio-bubble fatigue. So, your batsmen, two good batsmen, one bowler, they're all gone now. Sanju Samson's captaincy has been not that inspiring. That go-for-glory match against Punjab Kings, it didn't help him. Although that century was great, but it did not help him in his confidence. Second, if I have to look at it, Rajasthan Royals should actually have been 3-0. Three losses, no wins. But they benefited from Delhi Capitals having a bad day in the office as far as captaincy is concerned. Rishabh Pant not bowling out Ravichandran Ashwin. And against Chennai Super Kings, they were totally bamboozled by Moeen Ali and Ravindra Jadeja. So, problems galore for Rajasthan Royals. But at the other end of the scale, you would normally associate it with this team, but no. Royal Challengers Bangalore are on a different level altogether.
Yeah, and it's been very surprising in a good way, because normally I think with RCB, we've always kind of associated them as perennial underachievers because they've made the finals twice, never won it. And you always kind of expect so much from them. They always flatter to deceive. That hasn't quite been the case this season. And surprisingly, very surprisingly, one of their star performers has been another much maligned IPL player, a player in the IPL at least, and that's Glenn Maxwell. Suddenly out of nowhere, this man has found some gear which has allowed him to click and show the world just how good a batsman he is. I mean, we've all seen it. We've all seen how well he plays in the wing bash. We've all seen how well he plays internationally. In the IPL, aside from maybe 2014, he's always started to deceive. But this year, it looks different.
I think it's the ABD factor at the other end.
Yeah.
Because I will say that why did he not duel in Punjab Kings? Because Chris Gayle was there. But Chris Gayle was not a certainty every single time he started for Punjab Kings. Look at the match against Punjab Kings and Sunrisers Hyderabad. Gayle is not a starter. When you have an aggressor, when already you have a guy who is assured that yes, he will be a constant and he will take the attack with the opposition, it makes Maxwell's job a whole lot easier. It gives him much more clarity. If ABD does not get you, then the big show will. Glenn Maxwell, if he doesn't get you, then AB de Villiers will. So that clarity in his batting, a clear KRA, like all us employees, many of our time we struggle to know what is our KRA, key responsibility area. Maxwell represents us. So Maxwell has gotten an organization and a team now that has given him a clear key responsibility area. Go for it. And it's working.
And yeah, you can say that there's definitely less pressure right now because of, obviously, you know, the batting lineup he's dealing with here is far better. Punjab Kings was very top heavy. You knew if you got KL, you knew if you got Mayank, you knew if you got Gayle. And that was the game sorted. Because, and then the lower order was dependent solely on him. Here, that's not necessarily the case. And obviously, you know, not having that pressure factor so much where he's not necessarily supposed to be an anchor for the middle order, but can go out there and do his thing, has benefited him massively. But I mean, it wouldn't be fair to say that, you know, it's just the Maxwell show. Because obviously, as we say, ABD is proving that age is just a number. The man is aging like fine wine. Kohli is Kohli. And of course, he's not really lit the world on fire just yet. But we all know what a dangerous operator he can be. So I think as far as RCB go, getting RR in this game is like perfect timing because they are lamb for the slaughter and these men are the slaughterhouse.
Exactly. I mean, they can make it 4 out of 4. I mean, let's make it very clear. RCB are heavy favourites heading into this match. Kohli has not fired. Devdutt Padikkal has not fired. If those two fire, then God help the opposition. And in the lower middle order, you have the likes of Kyle Jameson. Jameson's also a very handy back, if you have to look at it. He's also done well with the ball. With Rajasthan Royals, you just have the Chris Morris effect and David Miller. Sanju Samson, you know what the trend is. He'll begin one or two matches in grand style, but after that, the remaining 12 games are a total disaster for him. So, that consistency factor is not there in Rajasthan Royals. They don't have those wow individuals who can intimidate an opposition. Jofra Archer was that. Ben Stokes was that. They're gone.
Both are now. Yeah.
But with Royal Challengers Bangalore, you have AB de Villiers. I mean, let me make it very clear. They can repeat 2016. They had a similar start like this. They finished the league status on top. They were only undone by a very inspirational Sunrisers Hyderabad. They can go the distance. Their batting is sorted. Their bowling is sorted. They just have to maintain the consistency.
And I think that's the only challenge for them right now, because everything is going right. You know, their starting 11 is fairly consistent, picks itself. They've been performing well. Whereas for Rajasthan, it's the exact opposite. I mean, they don't have those wow intimidation factor players. And normally with RR, there has always been a case of, you know, the sum being greater than his parts. But right now, a lot of even those players, the players who are expected to at least put in solid, if not, you know, spectacular contributions, are not really delivering the goods. And again, you're left reliant on the Javathia, on, I'm forgetting the left-arm seamer's name, the young kid, what's his name? Zakaria. And you're again reliant on a Riyan Parag. All good players, but I think these guys should be your supporting act rather than your main act. And that's been their problem.
That's been their problem. I mean, it's like this. You have bought a Mercedes car, but the engine inside is of a motorcycle. That is the situation of the Rajasthan Royals. They have got players, but as you said, the sum of its parts are also not working for them. Now the batting has been robbed of Ben Stokes, Liam Livingstone. They only have Josh Butler. But even Butler is not having that kind of an impact like he had in 2018. So now they have a big problem. With the bowling, Unadkat is there. Luckily, they are playing at the Wankhede. So, let's look at the flip side. Even they have a bit of experience. They can put Royal Challengers off their path. Unadkat can take the 2-3 wickets. Mustafizur has been decent. Morris has been decent. But apart from that, who? They may pick Shreyas Gopal, because Shreyas Gopal has a good record against AB de Villiers and Virat Kohli.
I'll never forget 2018 when he was getting them out twice, both games.
Twice. In fact, he's the only guy, he's the only bowler to have dismissed AB de Villiers and Virat Kohli twice in both editions of it, 2018 and 2019. But now, now he's not finding a place.
Yeah, obviously, I think the team combinations, permutations, combinations, I think are a need to figure out, because whatever they're doing right now, it's not working for them. And as you said, I think the main problem with their bowlers is that you're mentioning, you said, you know, Zakaria, Unadkat, Morris, all have wickets in them. The flip side is that none of them are able to contain.
Yeah.
All three of them run at some point or the other. And Mustafizur, I think there was a lot of expectation from him, especially considering there would have been pressure that he's coming in to replace someone like Archer. But he's not quite found his best, because him, at his imperious best, has two things. Yorkers and a killer slow ball, neither of which he's been able to execute perfectly. That he's done okay is still testament to him, but, you know, obviously there's not enough there. And they probably need to work harder on containing or making that pressure talk, rather than just getting the wickets.
I think Mustafizur has not been the same ever since he underwent that shoulder reconstruction surgery. I mean, before that, his Yorkers, his cutters, his slow balls were simply magnificent. Sunrisers Hyderabad had the option of two buffers. They had Bhuvneshwar, they had Mustafizur in those death overs back then. But ever since that shoulder reconstruction surgery, has not been the same. And unfortunately, that has seen a stock plummet. Then Chris Morris takes wickets, but again, average economy rate of 9. So it balances itself out in a very negative way. Number 2. Number 3, Chetan Zakaria, very nice, but still inexperienced. You can't expect a whole lot from him. Unadkat, after that 2017, I don't know, maybe not been picked regularly, not been performing well, but he's carrying the momentum from 2020 onwards till now. He's been decent. That one win came because of Unadkat's 3 wickets. So, there is hope, but they have to fire in unison.
That's the key. And I think that's where, you know, having those difference makers is important. Because, you know, if these players have an off day, at the very least, you can rely on your difference maker. Similarly, if your difference maker doesn't quite fire, then the team picks up the slack. At the moment, RR have neither, and it's impacting them very poorly.
Absolutely. So, looking at the playing sheets and looking at form and momentum heading into this match, I will say Royal Challengers Bangalore tick all the boxes. But yeah, you don't know when a weakness can crop up. Like for Mumbai Indians in the game yesterday against Delhi Capitals, suddenly their middle order looks a bit vulnerable. Amit Mishra got Rohit Sharma, he got Hardik Pandya, he got Kyron Pollard. The middle order looked a bit vulnerable. If you get through them, then actually you can beat the Mumbai Indians. We can boast about it that it might have been a one-off. But no, I think they are looking a bit vulnerable. With RCB, if they repeat 2020 all over again, then I'm sorry, boss. You're not winning the title again. You need momentum. RCB are a momentum-based team because the players rely on that. If they don't fire, if they again suffer towards the fag end, sorry, boss. All the good work has been undone.
Yeah, and right now, as you said, like given everything that we're seeing right now, whether it be team selections, whether it be form, momentum, overall feeling, I think it's hard to look past RCB for this match. But who knows? I mean, RR might just bring a surprise. It's unlikely, but you can never really rule it out.
So far, if we have looked at the teams and how their performances are in IPL 2021, so far, the teams that have made the less chopping and changing have actually won more matches.
True.
That is why Sunrisers are at the bottom. Four changes, three changes, three changes, two changes. Doesn't matter, boss. PBKS, again.
That's what panic does to you, really, is that you start analyzing what's wrong, and rather than sometimes what you just need is to give it a little time. Maybe that's what RR did as well, because you know that team is someone, they're full of dependable players, and sometimes these players need a little bit more time to get fired. If that happens, you could potentially see them making a run to the playoffs.
Hope so, but I see it very hard. I mean, RR are losing momentum. They have lost two games in a very big way, if I have to look at it. Yeah. They lost, mentally I will say, they lost it to Punjab Kings, but they were hammered by Chennai Super Kings. Yeah. So, that will not put them in a good seat heading into this clash, which has a far superior batting lineup. Chennai Super Kings have players, but RCB's batting is simply too good. So, my vote, if you have to look at who's the winner of the RCB-RR game, even before a ball is bowled, it's RCB.
Definitely RCB. This is a bit of a one-sided match. But, I mean, of course, we've been wrong in the past. And I think for the sake of the TV viewers, for the fans, I think we'd hope that that's not really the case. But that's only something that we're going to find out on the day of the game itself. Do join us that day and afterwards for more videos, more analysis, more breakouts, whatever it is you need, you can find it all at Sports Rumo. Thank you very much for joining us. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. And remember, if you want the best of sports, you have to look no further than Sports Rumo.